He was lean as the old dog that walked by his side, and as tough as the tie strap he wore. His face was a legend of living it hard, and his years numbered more than 80. His old eyes had seen more than we'll ever know of the far reaches of the inland. He was part of this country, it surely did show, like the scars on his work-hardened hands. From the high-crowned old felt hat that sat on his head, to the scuffed and worn heels of his boots, with his sweat-caked spring leggings and old faded jeans, he was out back down to the grassroots. And his old checkered shirt with the collar all frayed, and the yard dust and flies on his back, as he took out the makings before he sat down, I knew this was a man you could back. He talked long and low of the country he'd seen, and the changes that came with the years, of the ne'er-ending battle of living out here, the hardships, the heartbreak and tears, the big droughts that took over and crippled the land, and the dust storms with no sign of rain, the creeks and the dams long empty and dry, and you wondered would they ever fill again. He drew maps in the dust of the country he'd known, where water was sure to be found. Pinpointed landmarks should someone go wrong, the type of terrain all around, where the wild horses watered by light of the moon, and the gorges where old pikers feed, their pads not as deep as they were years ago. They're part of a vanishing breed. We got up and shook hands, and he said, so long, mate. With his hat knocked the dust off his jeans, stamped on the butt, grounded into the dust. Old habits die hard, so it seems. His old frame seemed much straighter as he walked away. There was naught I could give him he'd need. He was part of our history that shaped this old land. Yes, part of a vanishing breed. He was part of our history that shaped this old land.